Hey.
I've missed you
Look
so much.
Look at your
much.
Hair. It looks
Do
fabulous.
You like it?
I love it.
Michael? You brought home an extra suitcase.
You noticed?
Any particular reason?
Maybe presents.
For whom?
Maybe I'll show you later. In person. Is that bubble bath I smell? You got a bubble bath around here?
It's hot and it's waiting.
What a coincidence, so am I. Come here, baby. Kiss me. Is our bell broken? I mean, who the hell is that banging on our door?
I know that knock. I know that.
Well, tell him to go away.
I'll get it. Hi, darling. This isn't a very good time.
Hi, sweetie. Hi. How are you doing?
I need your help. Both of you.
Is this really serious?
Life or death. I am about to do the most self-destructive, potentially catastrophic thing I've ever done in my life, and I need the two of you to talk me out of it. You're not busy, are you?
So, let me get this straight. Both Simmons and Lopez are on duty tonight?
Yeah, you got it.
So you got this Sam guy to join in, huh?
Yeah, and he's bringing a friend, so we've got five to play.
You know I don't like playing poker with people I don't know. So who is this Sam guy anyway?
Well, he turned in some small hood for insurance fraud. Turns out, while we were talking, that he lives in the building. He's been looking for a steady poker game for a long time now.
So he's not a cop?
No, he's not, but he wanted to cut loose and celebrate.
You sure this guy knows how to play?
You gotta be a cop to play poker?
The last time you brought a civilian in, he wanted to play all those ladies' games where everything was wild.
Yeah, and if I remember, he also took you for $38.
Hmm? Yeah, that too.
Listen, if Sam and his friend take you for more than your $10 quota, I'll cover for you. Call it an early Christmas present. Yeah. Hey,
Hi.
Sam.
How you doing, man? Good to see you.
Yeah.
What's up?
The boys?
Boys, how's it going? Sam Fowler. Nice to meet you.
I'm Ed. This is Jerry. Nice Where's your you. Friend?
He's out parking his bike.
Hey, man. Sorry, man. I had to park my...
Oh, great. What's the matter?
We're playing poker with a bunch of cops.
What's up, you two know each other or what?
Oh, yeah, we've met.
Is there a problem, huh?
I don't have a problem. Do you have a problem, Jake?
Can I have a beer?
What's the matter? Harrison bust you or something?
Not yet.
Not ever.
Why don't we play some cards, boys? Why don't we do that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I am beginning to feel luckier by the second. Yeah, let me buy $20 worth.
Hey, man, I didn't know you knew this guy. He's only been in town a couple months.
I don't know him. Vicky does.
Oh, I got you.
He thinks I have an attitude.
Damn straight.
Can I ask you one question?
I don't know. Can you?
What are the stakes?
Nickel, dime, quarter.
You're not serious.
We're just cops, McKinnon. If you want to call up a couple of your little director friends, be my guest.
No, wait a second, Harrison. I think we could bump up the pot here just a little bit, don't you think?
Yeah, I don't have a problem. I sold a painting this morning. I'm okay.
You sold a what?
Can it, Jerry? What kind of stakes are you talking about, Jake?
The way my luck's been going lately, I got money burning a hole in my pocket. How high can y'all go?
Excuse me, this is your life and death matter?
Yes.
Finding out what Ryan Harrison is doing tonight, this is your potential catastrophe?
Mother, you can jump in anytime you'd like.
Victoria is interested in that handsome young policeman.
And?
And he's interested in her. And he said that he couldn't go out with her tonight because he had to play a poker game, which is obviously a cover.
That's right.
Oh, that's right. I mean, he just wouldn't have a Wednesday night poker game with the guys.
Why wouldn't he?
What man in his right mind would turn down a date with a beautiful woman like Victoria for an evening of poker and beer?
Maybe it was really good beer, Donna.
Oh, Dad!
Well, come on, look, I mean, why wouldn't the guy have a...
Some things in a man's life supersede his love life, all right?
Like what?
Poker.
Oh, Michael! He still doesn't get it.
No, he doesn't. All right, you want to know who Ryan is with, but you want to protect yourself.
Well, obviously, if he knew that I was chewing all my fingernails off trying to find out where he was and who he was with, I would think he would think that I was desperate or something.
Or something.
Hush up. All right, now let's think. Has he ever mentioned that he's seeing somebody else?
No.
Have you ever seen him with anybody else?
He brought Stacy to the clinic fundraiser, but doesn't count.
No, that doesn't count. What about work? Has he mentioned anybody at work?
All he talks about is the policeman. Oh, no.
What?
Oh, no.
What?
He could be seeing a policewoman.
Oh, he wouldn't do that.
Why wouldn't he do that?
Instead of you?
I don't believe
you're
this.
Right. Dad, really, he gave me this whole line yesterday about honesty and how it was so important to him and...
All right, so why wouldn't he be telling you the truth then about going out to play poker?
Well, Dad, isn't that obvious?
No!
He's a man.
Oh.
Of course, you're excluded from that category, darling.
Why, thank you, dear. I think.
So what you have to do is talk me out of tracking him down and catching him in flagrante depicto.
Delicto.
Whatever.
All right. Don't track him down and catch him in flagrante depicto.
Delicto.
Whatever.
So you think I should do it?
Absolutely.
Wait a minute. Didn't I just say that I thought that you...
Passionate and understanding. Don't jump to any conclusions. And if it turns out that he is with some little cupcake tonight and he's lied to you, then and only then do you make his life a living inferno. Just for the evening.
Okay, I've got to go.
Victoria.
What?
Victoria, stop.
Yeah,
wait,
what?
Talk. Did it ever occur to you to simply talk to him and tell him how you feel?
What do you mean?
Have you ever thought of just telling Ryan how you feel about him?
I mean,
just talk to him and tell him that you care for him.
Are you kidding?
No. Honey, I have always found the direct approach to be very refreshing.
So he married me. Call me in the morning and let me know what happens.
I'll try.
And darling, why can't you just once choose a nice, simple, uncomplicated man?
I did. He divorced me. I'll see you later.
So glad I could be of help. Donna, I want you to know if ever a conversation like that happens again, I'm not getting in the middle of it. You two talk because you talk a language I've never heard before in my entire life. What the hell is this? This looks like a bill for wedding announcements.
Well,
are you
yes.
and I getting married again, Donna? Or is this for Jake and Marley?
Yes.
Jake and Marley set a date, and you didn't tell me?
What's the matter?
Nothing.
You did it yourself, didn't you?
Did what?
You went and snuck into Jake's loft all by yourself.
That way, okay, Vicky?
Well, what did you find out? Did you find out that he was going behind your back with Paulina or what? Come on.
Nothing, and no, I haven't gotten my nerve up yet.
Oh, yeah, I know what you mean. I'm trying to get my nerve up to blow the whistle on Ryan's date tonight.
Oh, Ryan has a date?
Yes. He says it's just a poker game.
That old line.
Marley?
Just kidding.
Well, now, where have you been if you weren't breaking and entering?
I went to see Jamie.
Oh.
He said he saw Jake and Paulina together before. I thought I would just ask him about it again.
And?
He didn't want to talk about it. Paulina is his half-sister.
Oh, she's been his half-sister for 6 weeks. Please.
Well, he's loyal to her already. I don't know. He doesn't know anything for sure. Well, I know that the odds are against Jake. I don't know anything anymore. Riley, I told you I would help you case out Jake's law.
And what about Ryan and his poker game?
Well, I'll let it go. I'm mature enough to let it go.
No, you're not.
Marley, snooping around isn't exactly your style, and what you're trying to prove is a hell of a lot more important.
If Ryan is lying to you, the sooner you find out, the better. I'll be fine.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm going to stay here and try and get my nerve up.
Oh, please, that could take us all night.
Would you give me some credit, please?
I do.
Thanks. Wear sneakers.
Why?
The noise.
It's not my style.
Hey, it was just a little friendly, sisterly advice.
So, you're gonna go track Ryan down?
Yep.
Oh, I wish I had your gut sometimes.
Well, you just have to put fear in your back pocket. The way I see it, you have to acknowledge the danger, but you can't let it blow you away.
Vicky.
What?
I don't want to be right about this. That's why I'm afraid.
I know.
Well, good luck.
You too.
Are you sure you want to do this alone?
Yes! Sure?
Well, what if you find out that... Jake
I'll handle it.
It could hurt. I've been hurt before.
I know.
Be careful. See you.
Marley!
What?
I'm just really proud of you.
Forget it.
Too rich for me. Yeah, I'm out.
I can't hang with this one either. Anybody want anything?
How about a big piece of humble pie for the officer here?
Hey, I'm still in.
Not for long.
Oh, really?
Daring.
Maybe.
For the love of heaven, would you two finish out this hand? Thank you.
Foiled again.
Ryan, Jake, stale, man.
I think he's got something growing in his refrigerator.
Yeah,
your deal, Jake.
Boy, we are a glutton for punishment tonight, aren't we, Ryan?
Chickening out?
Well, I just know how underpaid you public servants are. I hate to take any more of y'all's money.
I am not having fun here, okay?
Cut the cards.
Can you rock me?
Yeah, I got
you. Hi.
You are home.
What? How did you find my house?
I'm a reporter, remember?
Look, what are you doing here? You can't be for the neighborhood.
Oh, I used to live in this building. I'm just checking out my old haunts.
Listen, I told you that I was busy tonight.
What is that smell? Are you smoking a cigar? Oh, I don't believe this.
Well, let's see. You know all the guys except for Ed and Jerry. Ed, Jerry, Vicky.
Oh, no.
There really is a poker game going on here tonight.
Surprise.
And Jake, where did you crawl in from?
Not her, too.
Why would you invite a guy like Jake to a man's night out?
I invited Sam. Sam invited Jake.
Vicky, I'm doing pretty well. Why don't you find somewhere else to play, huh?
Oh, you play?
Ryan, don't.
What?
Do I play?
Yeah,
let her play. We need somebody extra there. Vicky does not play poker with us.
Why not?
Because he knows I'll beat all your pants off.
Who's next, Ryan? Your grandmother?
What do you say, boys?
Yeah.
This was not gonna go that well.
I just have one little quick phone call to make before we start.
Sure. When I call all your little friends, we'll have a tea party.
Who is that guy?
He's a detective that I work with. Good. So you play five card stud?
Oh, five card stud, seven card stud, five card draw, high, low. Oh, let's see, baseball, I do them all. It's a good thing that we're not playing strip poker tonight because you would be pretty chilly. Excuse me. It's me. Yeah, Jake is at Ryan's. He's playing poker, if you can believe it. Listen, I'll keep him occupied for hours. You just go for it, okay? Oh, honey, you bet your life. I'm ready.
Listen, who taught you how to play poker anyway?
Mr. McKinnon. He was the master when we were growing up in Lassiter. I know all your tricks, don't I, Jake?
Mm-hmm.
The game is seven-card stud. One-eyed jacks and red threes are wild. We open, the jacks are better. Is that okay with you boys?
Well, I guess that Jerry had the right idea. Leaving before things got too ugly. Oh.
Sorry about bringing my buddy Jake. Didn't know he'd be bankrupting us all.
I'm out too.
Guess you lost your touch, huh, Vicky?
I just can't get keyed up when the stakes are so low.
Low? I lost 2 days' pay already.
I don't even want to think about it. I think I'm getting a stomachache with these potato chips.
What do you say? Yeah. I win back all your money for you boys.
You haven't won a hand all night.
Hasn't been worth my while. Triple the stakes. Just like the old days.
Vicky, you better have a lot of money to back up that big mouth of yours, Vicky.
I'm loaded.
Dear.
How about we make it simple? Five-card draw. What's the ante?
You say $300, Vic?
Yeah.
Lovely.
Excuse me, can I ask you a question?
Shoot.
Why are you doing this?
I hate Jake.
Oh.
I'll take any chance I can to beat him.
I'll take one.
Well, it takes two.
You're gonna lose your shirt, Vicky.
That ain't nothing next to what you're gonna lose in the long run, Jake.
Why don't we all take a little pizza break?
I'm not hungry.
I love to see you sweat, Vicky. I always have.
You think I'm sweating?
You've never been very good at bluffing, you know that?
Are you gonna see my bet?
Why don't I use this watch as collateral? It's worth
more. I know. What it's worth.
It's real, all right.
Show him.
Two pair. Kings. And aces.
Wow.
You're out of practice, Vicky. Way out of practice.
Wow.
That's all she can say is wow.
Vicky, you all right, huh?
She doesn't look pale.
Jake. Honey.
You better have brought your checkbook.
I may be a little out of practice. But doesn't three of a kind beat two pair? Doesn't it?
This isn't over.
It's over. I won. You lost all your money. It's definitely over.
One day you're gonna slip up, Vicky, and I'm not gonna be there to catch you.
Kofi! Sore loser!
Oh!
How did Jake McKinnon afford a watch like that? Check it out.
Where's that pizza you guys wanted? I'm starved.
So what else do you know how to do, Victoria?
You got about 10 years?
Drug-addicted moms, cheating lovers, crazy exes, and pregnancy scares. Being rich ain't all it's cracked up to be. Don't miss back-to-back episodes of 90210, today starting at 5 on SoapNet.